Welcome to CaseWare QuickVids. This QuickVid demonstrates the various ways to populate data within financial statements using CaseWare Financials. In CaseWare Financials, the financial statements are built using tables with rows and columns that contain cells. The data for these cells, including descriptions, comes from the working trial balance using either mapping or grouping codes to retrieve data. Using mapping and groupings ensures that client data from the working trial balance automatically flows into financial statements. As you can see, in my statement of income, there are many lines populated with data, and each is pulled from the trial balance mapped to the particular mapping number. However, not all content comes from the working trial balance. The statement, schedules, and notes are flexible enough to accept manual input and linkages. The cash flow statement operates in a similar manner, except individual line items access the analysis numbers created in the cash flows worksheet rather than mapping numbers. This video will cover the three methods of populating data: mapping or grouping, linkages, and manual input. Although mapping or grouping is generally specified by the template author, users can also specify or change the default for financial statements if permitted. Please note that for this demonstration, the Financials Canadian template is used. Open the Financial Statements document and select the Global Setup ribbon. I'm going to also navigate to my balance sheet. Locate the Mapping drop-down in the Balances section of the ribbon. From the drop-down, select the mapping or grouping to use. I want to keep my defaults, but you do have the option to map your trial balance to the mapping structure or up to 10 custom groups. Your selection here becomes the default. If you do not want to use the default selection, you can make local changes to override the global defaults where necessary. To do this, navigate to the Table Tools ribbon. Click in the table or row for which you want to specify the mapping or grouping. From the Edit drop-down, select Table Grouping or Row Grouping depending on which you'd like to change. Choose the specific mapping or grouping. I'm going to select Row Grouping and Lead Sheet. I will then choose Lead Sheet A to display the totals for cash. As you can see, the number with the mapping or grouping selection becomes shaded to indicate that an alternate grouping is used for the table or row. Now that we've looked at populating data through mapping and grouping, let's look at linkages. To demonstrate this, I'm going to navigate to Schedules. As you can see, there's a drop-down menu to the left of each row. Select the row that you want to create a linkage for. Then in the drop-down, choose Linkage. I'm going to populate the gains on disposal with a linkage instead of using the default mapping. Now go to the Case View linkage in the command bar, and in the linkage dialog that appears, choose the data to populate each cell. For this example, I'll choose the description, gains on disposal, and the totals for 2013 and 2012. This is executed on a cell by call basis. Close the linkage dialog and you will see that the row has been populated with data from the trial balance using the CaseView linkage. Lastly, let's manually input data. Go to the row where you would like to input manual data. From the drop-down menu, select Input. I will do this with the Other Revenue row. Type in data for the row and hit Enter. I will enter Commissions Revenue and I will enter the totals. Note that totals will appear with a solid gray background. Not all tables are equipped with a drop-down to change from mapping to input. When this option is not available, from the Table Tools ribbon, you can select the Input button. This will permit manual entry on the data cells for the selected row. This concludes the QuickVid on populating data in financial statements. For additional resources, including documentation and online help, see the related links. Thank you for watching CaseWare QuickVids.